everybody. I'm going to show you my car seats and do a review here on them because I think there needs to be some more information about them out available. I did tons of research on these seats before I bought them. I wanted some seats that would harness larger, taller, and heavier children, older children, because I wanted them in the 5-point harness. And so I narrowed it down to 3 seats, and I chose the Recaro Pro Sport in the end. The seat is highly rated. Every review I found on it was a good review, except for things that I didn't think would be a problem for me, like the length of the straps. The company had came out with longer straps. They're just what, and children could unbuckle themselves, but my children are older. I wasn't going to have a problem with that. So these were all rated 4.5 stars, and this is the sable color that I picked, and I was really, really happy with them until we installed them and my children started riding in them. Every installation I saw on YouTube never really showed underneath this padding, so I'm going to show you underneath so you know what to expect if you decide to go with this seat after I show you what we have here. So underneath here is the belt path. And the belt travels along here, and it sits basically in contact with your children. Now, what I've noticed on many of the seats, they don't. The seat belt is in a path behind the plastic that comes in contact with your child. And I think that's extremely important because what we have here is we have a gap no matter what angle, what car this is in. It's been in other vehicles. We always have a gap here where the seat belt does not sit flush with the seat. So there's about, as you see, about 1.5 inches, an inch to 1.5 inches, depending on which seat and what car we're in. So, of a gap. The problem is when my children are sitting here, that is digging into their back and causing them to sit with bad posture, which we have not been happy with. We've had these seats less than 6 months, and unfortunately, in the last week, my husband was rear-ended pretty badly in our other vehicle, and it's in the shop right now. So the insurance company is replacing our car seats because, if you don't know, when a car seat is in an accident, you are supposed to replace them. So we are replacing these, and we are not getting Recaros again because of this problem that we've been very unhappy with. I contacted Recaro and told them about my problem. And they were aware of my problem because they sent me 3 of these pads to put behind the child. Underneath the padding, obviously. I can't get it under there holding the camera. But we haven't been satisfied with that solution. It hasn't solved the problem. The children can still feel the seatbelt. And I don't know, it's making their body sit with their back arched, which I'm not happy with. So if you are in a situation like me, where you are looking for a safe car seat that you can 5-point harness your older children in, you have 3 choices, at least that I came up with. We have the Diono Radian RXT, you have the Recaro Pro Sport, which is this, and you have the Britax Frontier 80, or 90, I'm sorry, there's the 82. The 90 is what I'm replacing these with. And I will do a future review once I get those in here. I just installed these so that I can show you before I take them to the insurance company and get rid of them for once and for all. So, the Diono, the reason I'm not going with that is we actually did go to a store and have my 9-year-old sit in one. And even though they're supposed to be 9-year-old and 7-year-old, they both tried it. They're supposed to be for larger children. The Diono in the 5-point harness is supposed to fit 20 to 80 pounds. And 50 to 80 inches in the, or I'm sorry, 50 to 120 pounds in the booster. The maximum height is 57 inches. So for those two, I tried my children in them, and in the shoulders, it was just not wide enough for my children. So I'll show you one of my sons, my biggest son, sitting in this seat, so you can see. I just don't think it's realistic to put larger, my children are not huge, but larger children in the Diono. They're great seats because of the three I listed, they're the only one that you can rear face. So they're a great seat to start with and then transition into a, your older child. But for my children, I don't think past 6 years old, the Diono would work for us. The Pro Sport, as you've seen, I don't like it, but it does go 20 to 90 pounds for the harness and 30 to 120 pounds when you use it as a booster, 27 to 50 inches as a harness, and 37 to 59 inches as a booster. Now, the Britax holds the largest children, and we have tried my children in them, and they are, I would say, comparable to the Recaro in width and height. They go higher. So I think they'll fit my children the longest. They go 25 to 90 pounds in the harness for the Britax, 40 to 120 pounds for their booster, so, and then 30 to 58 inches in the 5-point harness, and 45 to 62 inches as a booster. So, and the Britax has something new that I haven't tried. It's the click tight install, which I think I'm going to really like, and I will review it once we get them in here. So on width, the Diono is the smallest. It's 17 inches wide, so if you don't have an Expedition or something that's wider, you might need to go with the Diono. This Recaro is 18 and a half inches wide, and the Britax is only an inch wider at 19 inches. So those are your three choices. If you're in the situation like me where you're looking for something that's going to 5-point harness larger children, those are the three seats you're going to be looking at. The Diono Radiant RXD, the Recaro Pro Sport, or the Britax Frontier 90. And they do have a couple other models that I do think go up to the same heights and weights, but you'd have to double check on that. So again, this is the main problem with the Recaro. I wish somebody would have told me before I spent over $700 on three seats. So I hope to save you the trouble of figuring this out yourself. So thanks for watching. So I thought I'd show you all three of them loading up. I have a 9-year-old, a 7-year-old, and a 4-year-old. Let's go, guys. Get in. And you can see how they fit in these seats, in case you still decide to go with him after what I showed you with the seatbelt. So you see his height. He fits in there. And he's my largest. He's the 9-year-old. And how much do you weigh?
75 pounds.
75 pounds. So he's still able to sit in the 5-point harness. And I feel much safer with him in a 5-point. There's the 4-year-old. And the 7 down there. Sit back, bud. Let me see ya. They've been playing out in the heat here. So that's it. They're easy to buckle. Everything else is wonderful about these seats except that one major, major flaw that I think eliminates them as an option for me. I would never buy them again. See you later.